Hey and howdy everyone, welcome to day 4, which is wild. Today, I had a little bit more energy, so I want to kind of show you how I produce in Logic. I'm not going to really do anything specific, but I'm going to be showing you a song that's already out in the world, so I don't have to leak projects and stuff, you know? So let's get into it. So as you can see, it's a very sparse track, however, it is very, very dense. Like, I do, my bestie David, he gave me this really cool idea to do like a reverb drum track and then put it in a stack. It's pretty cool. If you don't know what that means, I don't blame you. But yeah, like I did like string sections and stuff, and you know, that's my vox. And if you want to see something really crazy, this is the mix window. Yeah, it's just like endless. Don't ask me how I did all of this. This was like a school project that just kind of like became a lot more. And as you can see, it's very colorful. So yeah, that's big vibes. And this is a more maximalistic kind of track. So there's those, I have two very different kind of drum things happening. I'm not gonna get into it because again, this is a new song. Bass, I have two basses for different purposes, which make, like, there's a very like normal bass and a very electronic synthy bass. Those are all the pianos. I recorded piano on this of me, and a lot of them are doubled. So like this one is doubled with this just for like extra texture and volume. It's pretty fun. We have a string section and like texture instruments. I love adding organ, and this is like a melody instrument. I have like a little brass section, and that's all the vox. It's a lot. I know. I haven't finished color coding this. This is my sister playing the flute. Yeah, this is almost done actually, but I don't know when it's coming out, so you can't ask me. One thing I figured would be kind of cool to talk to you about is how I get ready to do something like that. I make all my own charts. This one specifically is like 8 pages of music. Here, I can show you the pre-chorus since I showed you that the other day, yesterday. So like, literally this is almost note for note. I do little changes as I go along, but like this is like the basic melody over chords. I have to, you have to count out everything kind of like before you do it, because otherwise it's gonna be very messy. And that's what all of those weird rainbow things were at the top of the Logic project. That's like, this is me planning. But yeah, this melody is really fun because it's a lot of like 16th note patterns. Hold on. If you don't know, I'm a music student, so this is literally what I do all the time. For this song specifically, it's like a da 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 da. There's a section in the chorus where it's like da 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 da. It's pretty fun. It's a lot of fun to like play around with, and I'm recording background vocals into that one, so hopefully we'll get some more work done on that soon. I do. What's it called? Have another one to work on today. So I can show you a little bit of my setup. It's almost done, it's just like a few extra sections. You'll see what I mean. This one, this is another song. I wrote this last year. It still doesn't have like a real name. I can't find anything that I think like sums it up. We're calling it Female Rage as of right now, even though that's definitely, like, it fits the theme of the song, but it isn't like what it is. Gotta talk to my people about that. And by my people, I mean my sister. But it's a lot of work. It's like, that's, I think it's 5 pages. See, and then there's just like, I do little changes in the verses and the pre-chorus, which is pretty normal for a pop song, just like kind of changing slightly as you go along. And then this one's pretty, it's a lot more simple compared to the other one, but like the other one is 8 pages. So yeah, So basically, it's just filling in the blanks for me, and then I can get started writing the tracks for this one. Yeah, the vibe for this song, which, again, running title, not official, is definitely like Who's Afraid of Little Old Me, kind of like Reputation, kind of like F You by Lily Collins, but like more minor. That's the big vibes. Yeah. Honestly, it's kind of hard to find motivation to do anything when it's literally soup outside. Like, if you haven't seen, like, the weather, the temperature graphs for America right now for the summer, it's, like, wild. Like, for, like, 2 weeks, it was, like, 95% humidity, looking like it was about to rain, but it didn't every single time. Or if it did, it was only for, like, 30 minutes. And constant gray clouds, it was soup. Like, it's so thick, you can't breathe. And I had asthma when I was little, but it comes back. Because I'm allergic to, like, dust, and I have a black lab and a cat and stuff, you know? So, like, dust is very unavoidable. And it's, like, for me, hard to breathe outside, and, like, my allergies get so bad that I cannot sing. Like, yesterday I was practicing, and the back of my throat closed up because I was so congested, even though I take a lot of allergy medicine for a bunch of different reasons and stuff. It's just... that's just life, man. But anyways, we're gonna do the tarot reading really quick, and then I'm gonna work on my little sheet, and then, yeah, that's it for today. And I'll see you all tomorrow.
Okay, here we go. We're gonna try and get through this as quickly as possible because I hate editing. Woo! Say hi, Maddie. Okay. Yeah, so today my dog rolled around in shit and he smelled like shit and I'm not happy about it. But anyways, let's go to the daily reading. Okay, this thing you're seeing on the screen right now is our summary card of the day. It is the Eight of Diamonds, as you can probably see, unless you're blind, but I'm sorry. And it stands for quality of craft, which is probably in regards to the banging track I'm finishing right now, okay? That's right, it's the Six of Cups. And the Six of Cups means generosity, nostalgia, and reconnecting. Looking to the past, but avoiding from living in it anymore, because that's not healthy! That's right, it's the Page of Pentacles. No, not me, the Page of Pentacles. Ambitious, focused, and loyal, and you're tied to the earth and to the body, and assistance will be there when you need for it, which basically means I'm gonna keep doing my job, bro, even though it's not really a job. I'm not getting paid for it, bro. You hear that? You hear that? That's called the Four of Wands, upright. Actually, no, it's Sands. Sands is Ness. I don't know his Ness Sands. I don't know. And that's just a theory, a game theory. But anyways, the Four of Wands upright cards to celebration, stability, and pride and satisfaction, which basically means it's my birthday soon. And I get to hang out with my sister who pretends that she hates me because I'm really awesome and epic, guys. But anyways, that's really it for today. And I'll see you tomorrow. Say goodbye.
No.
Goodbye.